Warning, adventure activities can be extremely dangerous. Please use extreme caution when out in the elements, and if you should, go ask your mom. Now, go ahead and in. And you know, where are we at today, James?
Peralta Trail.
You know, what makes this so special?
Well, Peralta Trail is where a lot of this stuff begins.
Well, you know, one of the problems you're going to deal with if you're going to hike in the winter is there's a parking lot full of people down there, James.
Pretty busy up here.
You know.
This goes to one of my theories, but okay.
And what is your theory?
How many people are up here today? How is no one stumbling upon it? This mountain looks like a shopping mall.
You know, I'm going to take a look, and I'm going to show you why.
All right.
And not only, we're going to find out why in really a pretty quick time. It's not going to take long. Because a lot of people don't realize what they're getting into when they get up to the Superstition Mountains. That there's a reason why this place is so difficult and unique. Because of the landscape itself. So we're going to walk down here on this trail about half block, get out of the parking lot, and we're going to take a look at an area of why this could be so difficult to even work this one trail.
And here we go.
So what I'd like to do is we'll take this location. Now we're only about a half block to a block right off of the trail, right?
Yep.
Let's take a look at this. Look at the density of this. Look at the density of trying to get into this area right here, or even over here. Look at the density in this. What it would take for you to physically look at the entire trail here, and look how difficult this is. I mean, it could be right here off the side of this trail and you wouldn't know it because you can't get through this. And then you're filled with cat claws and things like that. Look at this whole mountainside here. Now, you'd have to physically go through each and every one of this square feet. Now, this little area right here, if you were looking through every section of it, would take you a day. And the problem is nobody wants to spend a day going through an area that potentially might not be the area, right? So look at this. And this is what you deal with here. You deal with vegetation that is unbelievably difficult. So even though, yeah, this is a highly trafficked trail, probably a couple hundred people will go down and up this today. But they're not getting left or right, right? So even though these are high traffic, you'd be a bloody mess if you tried to cram through here. So let's take, for example, right here. You could have something hidden right here and you wouldn't be able to see it. And that's why we made that statement that that fire up there is going to burn this vegetation. So if the mine is over there, you potentially could see it because the growth will come back and it'll come back pretty quick, and whatever was there or hidden, you wouldn't be able to find it. So what's your theory, James, after, you know, talking about the density of this? What do you think?
I still think there's so many people up on this mountain, and there were so many people specifically looking for this, doing what we were just talking about, that it's still hard to believe it could be here. But you are accurate in that it would take days and days and days to methodically pick through all this very dense brush.
Well, let's look over here. Go over there for me, if you would, just to take a look. And I'm not trying to be, well, you know me, I am trying to probably.
Nice, tough. I mean, look at that. Bushwhacking is rough, but.
But look at that, how dense that is. And I'm not saying it's there by no means, but look at that.
Yeah.
I mean, look at this density. And then you've got a sheer wall up here, right?
Well, you know, I mean, it's definitely, you know, it could be hidden somewhere, but I still skeptical.
Well,
a little more than skeptical.
You know, I guess the point I'm trying to make is there's nothing wrong with being skeptical because, you know, a lot of sound judgment has come from skepticism. I believe that, right?
Well, absolutely.
But I guess the point I'm trying to make right now is, could it be here? Could this area hide the secret of the Lost Dutchman's gold?
Well, without a doubt, it could. Does it? I don't know, but it could.
Well, right now, I'm going to take that, James.
I think that's...
Okay, look at the camera, though. Don't be like... So...
It could be.
So it could, it could.
It could be. I just remain quite skeptical that it is.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
It really does.
Okay.
But cool. I, you know, and I'm not trying to win. I am.
No, you know, but it is good because that's this whole thing. That's this whole thing is two different perspectives. Dan, remember the last time we were here?
When the last time we saw water?
No, like that?
It's been a while, hadn't it? It's been a while since we've seen water up here.
Last time you were here, that lizard drank out of your...
Oh,
I
forgot about that. We're not in a hurry, you know, ain't a race. Right.
So I'm gonna say the trail's very different today.
Trail is.
You think they have the gold? You think they have the gold?
You know, I'm gonna say no.
Yeah?
I'm expecting there to have to be some type of bag or backpack, right?
True. What if they're doing it piece by piece?
Kind of like Johnny Cash's Cadillac.
Yes.
One piece at a time. I'm going to say I feel comfortable they don't have it.
You're confident today.
Yes.
Okay.
Now, I don't know how you feel, but I feel pretty comfortable, James, that...
They look like they're carrying $200 million worth of gold. Their faces do not scream. Look what I got.
You know, James, we just stopped on the trail and I looked up here. And here's what I said. If that gold was in any one of these... up here on this ridge line, right?
Yeah.
You'd never find it in 150 years. No possible way that you would find that gold unless you had some clue that you thought it was there. Because if you had to traverse that, you're talking almost impossible. And you know, back in the day, those miners with the skill set they had, they could have traversed that. And so that's what makes this thing so difficult, but I'm staying so positive about it because it could easily be here on a trail that you've walked by 1,000 times. If you think about it, James, look at Black Mesa.
Yeah.
People have driven by that thing 60,000 times, and 1/2 mile, or less than that, off the highway is one of the biggest ruins I've ever seen.
Right.
And people, we drive by it all the time. So could there be a cave up here? Absolutely there could be. There's not even a question. It's just up to us to figure out and find it. James, you think this could be a sign of where the gold is?
Yes, it totally is. It's right there. We just got rich.
Look at that. That's easy. Is that a sign? Sign that people have a lot of, too much time on the trail.
Go with this, ancient
hieroglyphic, yes.
Ancient scribblings of the map keepers. Yeah, no, there's another thing I want to throw out is the amount of people that have now been up here disturbing any of the glazes, the cactus, the original markings of the Jesuits, the miners, prospectors, etc., etc.
You think a little Stephen was still here?
Yeah.
If we could find his cross, you know what? That might be the best clue we could have. If you know who little Stephen is out there, look him up, because he might have been here, and he was definitely looking for treasure, and he was definitely marking the desert with crosses. So it's definitely a possibility.
Just get some air.
Now, the first thing on the trail that I've seen that might have some clues to this, even though we're looking Lost Dutchman, we're going by a cave up there they call Geronimo Cave. And a lot of people believe that that's where the gold is at Geronimo's cave that's right above that level. Now, there's no...
They believe, let's say.
Well, there's no history that he was ever here, but we know Geronimo did travel through this area.
But that was just named not yes, too long ago.
It was a cool name, though.
Exactly.
But, that, you know, even though that's a marker of Geronimo, I'm not saying Geronimo had it, but there is a cave up there. So I think it's an area that when we're up here, we need to go take a look at. Just to take a look at so everybody can see how and what we do to try to make sure that we're tracking everything we possibly can.
Exactly.
And the big deal today is, you know, there's a lot of flash floods that can happen up here, especially since the vegetation's down a little bit because of the fire. And we want to get in here and get out of here today. You know, we're not staying all night tonight because, you know, with the weather like it is, it just isn't a good day to do that when we'll have weeks that will be, you know, a little better weather. So right now, I've been in here and I've been in flash floods here, and you do not want to be here when it starts pouring.
Good call.
Because I had a creek crossing down there about 6-7 years ago that was not,
yeah, man.
Let's just say it wasn't the most fun time I've had.
If it rains, you should be up there, not down there.
Yeah, that's true. Let's get moving on the hill.
What did you see there?
Now look at that. And I've been by here. Here's another one of those. I've been by here 1,000 times, right? Yeah. Look at that RD there. Okay, and that is been hammered. Somebody spent a considerable time hammering that. And a lot of this stuff comes down to the light, right?
Yeah.
You know, the right light, you see the stuff. Yeah. Even the Dutchman's map, you know, set at a certain time, basically.
Yeah.
And so that's one thing out here that's kind of funny is the light can completely change, and something you see or don't see stands out like a sore thumb.
Today when we were talking the needle, but if you were looking for a shadow of a needle, today wouldn't be the day.
Exactly.
So that's a very good point you bring up. I didn't even think of that as we were walking up here, that like the shadow would have no relevance for us today. And depending on the time of the year and all sorts of other variables.
You know, but I think one thing today that I hope we accomplish is just to get that compass, right? That compass to try to figure out,
yes,
as we make this loop. We have to go look at it, and we have to really look at how we're going to attack and assault this area that, you know, again, up here. It could be in any one of these crevices. And I'll guarantee you, as many thousands of people as walk by here, there's only been a rare few that's ever even been anywhere near that mountain right there.
So that would be going on a theory that the maps are all bogus, right?
See, and that's the thing, is that the only problem is, I do believe, a lot of people have stuck to the map.
Absolutely.
And they haven't found it.
So one of the things you're pushing on in this little journey of ours is that step outside the maps.
Step outside the circle, get a fresh view. Okay. You know, guys 100 years before us couldn't find it.
Yeah.
Doesn't mean it wasn't here. It just means that maybe...
Not where they were looking.
you know, whatever they read or whatever they thought was not accurate.
I like that. See, that's good. I'm gonna work with you on that.
Well, you know, again, let's go back to the Indian ruins that we go to. You know, nobody knows what the petroglyphs mean, right?
Correct.
So you can interpret them however you want to.
Yes.
And so we can interpret this map however we want also.
Well, that definitely, you know, there's two schools of thought on that, because, you know, they do have the breakdowns of what they believe they meant through other stuff, so the map could be interpreted in similar ways or not, and it could give you fresher perspectives, possibly more accurate. So, okay, I'm gonna bite on that one, and we'll continue on.
Well, what about one thing, too, also real quick, is that we have technically the easiest set of tools, and we have technology that even up to today, nobody had. I mean, we've got phones that can actually help us pinpoint locations once we see them on Google Earth, right? And then we have the ability to hike out here, which, you know, a lot of people say, they go look here. Well, you go look there. You know, you go hike through the thickets and then tell me this is there. And then I'll help you haul it out. How about you, James? You gotta help them?
You know, I would. that's a whole other thing.
Would you skeptically help him haul out the
old? Very skeptically. That's a whole other thing. We're going to save that for another conversation, but say you found it. We're literally going to talk about this another day, but there is something that comes into play with if you actually found it.
James, I know that our goal is to go to the needle. And we're definitely going to do that, but I think the location we should look at least to mark it off the list, is right up there. I think Geronimo's cave. I mean, we know it's a good outcrop. You know, let's look and see if maybe they've dug the floor. Let's look and see if maybe that's a place that they could have hidden it.
All right. Well, that just made the list.
So I think that would be, since we're up here, and we need to get up there pretty quick before it starts raining, because we don't want to be on that slippery slope up there. Because I tell you what, you take a walk down that, and then we get a helicopter ride. No helicopter rides today.
I can't afford one.
Hey, you see the girl that got the ride off a camelback last night?
No, I missed
her. You know, she got off trail in the dark, and they had to go get her. Mm-hmm. In camelback, in town. Yeah. People take this stuff as a joke. And it ain't no joke. Man, they had everybody. They had like five, I mean, it's crazy.
Yeah, man, it's a bad time of year.
It's overwhelming how many places there are, you know, where possibly to be. Look at this mountain right here. Look at this. You know how difficult that would be to hike up that if you thought it was up there? So we got a daunting task, regardless if we believe it to be here. But the more I hike this, the more I believe that it's here and it just hadn't been found. Because this isn't some small little area that, you know, we could have traversed and been done. We would spend, on just the Peralta Trail, if we covered it thoroughly, 6 months, I believe?
Easy.
And that's just the Peralta Trail.
If you're doing it thoroughly.
You know, that's just the Peralta Trail.
To base stuff off a map. What were we talking about?
Well, you know, I've never seen this. I've been by here, James, and this is no exaggeration, 25 times, maybe 30. I've never seen that
crevice
right there, ever. And so, and that's a huge crevice.
It is.
Now, to traverse over there, you know, and that's why, you know, you got to use the maps, but it's the light today. I never would have saw that if the light would have been on it. I guarantee you. And that's exactly what I'm looking for in the Lost Dutchman. I'm saying that that is exactly the type of stuff we're looking for, that if we can be lucky enough to get the right light and the right time of day and the right time of the year with the sun, you know, we might find this. But it's that elusive right there. That's a huge crevice up there.
That is. Did not have seen it, yeah. Well, one of these days, we definitely need to shoot that way.